Ernesto Guevara, or Che Guevara as we know him, was born not on June 14, 1928, as his birth certificate states, but the previous month, May 14, 1928. His parents had his certificate date changed, as they weren't married when Ernesto was conceived, so they hid this fact in order to protect themselves from criticism. In 1948, Che entered the University of Buenos Aires to study medicine. In 1950, he decided to substitute his college pursuits with two motorcycle trips through the rural areas of northern Argentina and most of South America. These excursions ended up vastly changing his view on politics, himself, and the world around him. After he returned to Argentina, he completed the rest of his college studies and received his medical degree in June 1953. After the graduation, he set out from Argentina once again, which began his new stage in life as a fighter and leader in the Cuban Revolution. Contrary to those who support Che shirts, he wasn't fighting for cultural change, but for a traditional communist Marxist revolution. He didn't care about personal freedoms and rights. In fact, Che went as far to say that he wanted an individual to disappear from the nation, and that it is a criminal act to think of individuals. Yes, the government that Che helped overthrow was very bad, but he was just replacing it with another form that would censor and regulate its citizens and withhold their rights. After the Batista regime collapsed, Castro put Che in charge of the La Cabaña prison, supervising executions. Che oversaw executions of as many as 2,000 people while in command, and was given the name Butcher of La Cabaña. Not only low-ranking enemy combatants, but also people he suspected as spies, personal enemies, and deserters were all given swift trials and then executed, many by Che himself. The youth of today sport Che's image on shirts as a sign of rebellion, freedom, or revolution against the system. What they don't understand is that the very ideas they uphold are part of the system that Che wanted to abolish. By the mid-60s, the crime of listening to rock and jazz or effeminate behavior got thousands of youth yanked off Cuba's streets and parks by the secret police, and dumped in prison camps with "Work will make men out of you" in bold letters above the gates and with machine gunners posted on the watchtowers. Youth must refrain from ungrateful questioning of government mandates, commanded Che Guevara. Instead, they must dedicate themselves to study, work, and military service. And woe to those youth who stayed up late at night and thus reported to work tardily. Youth, wrote Guevara, should learn to think and act as a mass. One of the ironies of the legacy of Che Guevara is that it's the face of a communist leader that is used to sell t-shirts in capitalist America. You can pretty much divide those who wear shirts into two groups. People who know who Che Guevara was and what he did, and are actually communists or Marxist, and the other group, middle-class teenage rebels that Che would have had shot or imprisoned. After years of fighting, Che surrendered and was captured on October 8, 1967, in Bolivia. Contrary to traditional lore, he was armed and still had a full clip in his gun when he surrendered. Che was executed the next day, on October 9, 1967. With his hippie hair and revolutionary beard, Che is the perfect icon for the 60s mentality. If only those who glorify him today would see through the fog and realize the horrible things he did. So ends the history of Ernesto Che Guevara.